Get ready to match the stars. Greg Morris, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, and Meara, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74.
Thank you, Johnny Olsen. Thank you for being with us today. It's a pleasure to do business with you. How is everyone up here? And everybody down here is all right? Listen, I forgot to tell everybody that Ann Elder was nominated for an Emmy for writing the Lily Tomlin special. She's writing another Lily Tomlin special. And what else are you writing?
Well, it's funny. The networks have asked me to come up with the best of two possible shows that are on the air. One is The Waltons. And the other is Hawaii 5-0, and they're going to call it Pineapple's Way.
We're going to watch that. You just lost the Emmy.
For that.
No, she's also up for the C.B. Farnsworth show.
That's right.
Farnsworth show.
There's C.B. Farnsworth, our current champ, and Sue Hagee, his challenger. Hello there. How are you, C.B.? He's won a lot of money, $14,050. And how many games? How many games? Three games you won, right?
Three games.
Yeah. How do you feel?
Nervous.
No. How can you be nervous after winning all that money? Money makes you feel secure.
No, it doesn't.
How do you feel, Sue?
Very nervous.
All right. We're going to start with round two right after we give you a round of commercials. Here they are. Ready to go. Round two. Final round. 5-4 in favor of Sue. And Sue, you make a selection, if you would.
B, please.
You don't.
She wants B. Now, the only person who is playing
is Dr. Schweitzer.
That's right. Shall we read it together? No, I'll read it aloud to you.
No.
Charlie said, I have my income tax prepared by a trained monkey. You ought to try him. He works for blank. There it is.
Charlie said, I have my income tax prepared by a trained monkey. You ought to try him. He works for blank.
Right. She can read, too. Yes. Isn't that terrific? Did you hear it, Sue? Charlie said, I have my income tax prepared by a trained monkey. You ought to try him. He works for... Now, don't say it now. Wait till she finishes writing. Say something.
All right.
Anything.
The trick is she hasn't learned to write, so that's what makes it so hard for her.
All right. Sue? Charlie said, I have my income tax prepared by a trained monkey. You ought to try him. He works for...
Bananas.
He works for bananas, is what she said. He works for peanuts would have been a good answer.
That's right.
What else would have been good? Let's make her feel great.
An answer that's going to cause her entire career in about 2 seconds.
Really? Okay, may we see yours?
He works for...
I said it, and I don't care. I wish I had the same guy that worked for him.
Richard Nixon. Okay. Now, CB, you need...
I need...
One to tie, two to win. Ready?
No,
okay. Now, Brett and Ann.
Wait a minute.
Yeah, Brett and Ann are the only two. You're the only two who play.
Oh.
All right, ready. Just for Brett and Ann.
I have to...
Sharon wrote this poem, about her new husband.
Poem.
Before we were married, he gave me a mink. But this year for Christmas, he gave me a blank. It's a poem.
Well, I'm trying to rhyme it, sweetheart.
All right.
When we were married, he gave me a mink. But this year for Christmas, he gave me...
Would you like to do your dance?
What's your name again?
Not Vinny.
Sharon.
Oh, you mean...
Hold it, just the two.
Ann?
She's finished, and we're waiting for you.
She's finished?
She's finished.
She has rhythm, too.
Oh,
Brett's got rhythm.
Brett's got rhythm, according to Greg Moore.
I got rhythm.
That's enough. Stop fiddling with my cable.
No.
CB, Sharon wrote this poem about her new husband. Before we were married, he gave me a mink. But this year for Christmas, he gave me a...
Drink?
Drink. Drink is the answer. He's looking. He needs one to tie, two to win. Brett. Hello, Brett. Testing 1-2.
Oh, I wish that I couldn't think of anything that rhymed with me.
So what you put?
Stinks. Now you know the humiliation.
He's hoping you're going to say drink. Tell us what you did say.
I figured the marriage was ending. He gave her a wink.
Wrong.
It meant
all
it was
right.
A joke.
No match there. Two wins again. Congratulations. Well, CB.
It's adios time.
It's adios time is right. I'm sorry to see you go. You've been a very personable and interesting contestant.
You know, I just figured out what the initial CB stand for.
What?
Checkbook.
Well, he's got a lot of money to put in that checkbook. Right. $14,050. Oh, congratulations.
Thank you.
CB Farnsworth. Wink, eh?
Yes, wink. It's a logical thing.
All right.
Sorry.
Now, Sue, you've never been here before, so let me just explain. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Open blank. And the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Then if you go for the second one, it's $250. And if you match a third one, it's $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
What do you say?
The words of Sabu. Open sesame.
Open sesame. Okay, there's one.
Charles.
Charles, what do you say to this? Open.
Open the door, Richard.
That's an
throw
old song.
Throw out the tapes.
And throw out the tapes. No, open the door, Richard is an old rock song. What do you, who else?
Okay, Greg.
Greg.
Me? Oh,
have
boy.
You got one? Open. Yeah.
Account.
Open account.
Don't groan. It stinks.
All right. Open
oh,
account, open the door, Richard, and yeah. Open sesame.
Open.
You may choose one of those or think up one of your own. What would you like to do?
Open sesame.
You would like to open sesame. Okay. That's the one that Richard gave you. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where? First, may we see the $100 response. Open sesame is there right up the back.
Oh, great.
I thought I knew it was going to be there. I had a feeling it was going to be there, but I figured it'd be a little higher there. I'm curious to see what's under the $250 response.
Open
a door. Would that have matched open the door, Richard? Yeah, I guess it would have, okay. What do you think is under the $500? Open house.
Oh, sure.
I had that.
I had that.
None of the dummies up here thought of that, did they?
I did.
Oh, you thought of it. Oh, all right. Okay. Let's find out what's under the $500 response. Open house is right, audience. Okay, you've got the $100, Sue. That means you now play for 10 times that amount or $1,000. To collect, you have to match one celebrity. Which one will it be?
I'll try Richard.
Richard, okay. You get ready to write. You're going to face me. Here is the $1,000 question. This will have to be an exact match. Wash blank. That's W-A-S-H blank. All right, he's finished. Now, Sue, we call on you to give us an answer you think will match Richard's. Wash.
Day.
Wash day. All right. She says wash day will match you, Richard. What do you say? How do you respond
to
that?
She wants me, I'll be in the washroom.
Oh. In the washroom.
I'm sorry, Don.
She can't follow you in there, then.
Well, using a suit.
They're washcloth, and there are a number of good choices there. You didn't get together on that one. You're up to $200. You're going to play another game right after we have this message of interest for all of you.
Somebody should take
it. Now we're going to start a brand new game. To do that, we have to introduce a new player, and with a great deal of pleasure, we present Captain Ronald Smith. How are you, Captain? Would you please tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes, I'm a physician from Edwards Air Force Base. And
Edwards Air Force Base in Massachusetts?
No, that's in the Mojave Desert here in California.
Oh, in Mojave Desert. Oh, yeah, the Mojave Desert.
Right.
Yeah, that's nearby here.
That's right.
There's a Mojave Desert in Massachusetts.
It's a,
I know where that was. Well, he thinks everything is in Massachusetts.
There's a Camp Edwards in Massachusetts.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
What else about you, doctor?
I'm married, and I have a little boy, 2 1/2, and a little girl, about 4 months.
There's a little girl in Massachusetts.
Yes. What's your specialty?
Well, I'm in general practice.
Okay, good luck
to you. Oh, I have so many ailments for you.
No, none of that.
Does nothing to the mind.
Put the raincoat on.
He's here to play games, not to to check on your ailments. Good luck to both players. Here we go. Ready?
Okay.
All right, Captain, you as the challenger will make a selection.
B.
B it is. Here we go. Everybody plays. The mad scientist said to Nick... How would you like to be the first man on Earth to have a plastic blank?
Is that written there, that
That's what it says. But I get a little acting there. See, it says right there. Doesn't it say that? Say yes.
He, he, he.
Well, you can't say he, he, he.
How would you like to be the first man on Earth?
Would you like to borrow my glasses?
Plastic, okay.
Blank. Sir, watch it. I hear you over there in the corner, sir. Yes. Ready, Brett? Charles.
What did he say?
What? Mad scientist said to Nick.
We don't need it anymore.
No, okay.
No. Your pardon, Kate.
Well, I'm trying to stall it. Would you try reading it while they're writing? They're never going
to
finish.
I'll read it backwards. Blank, plastic, a half to earth on man first, the bee. They finish it?
No.
Two like you, would you?
Yeah, okay. All right, Captain Ronald Smith. The man, thank you. The mad scientist said to Nick. How would you How would you like to be the first man on Earth to have a plastic blank?
Brain.
Brain. He says brain. Did that occur to you, Greg? No. No. Uh-huh. What occurred to you? Nose. Plastic nose. Many of my friends have plastic
nose. Half the people I know have a plastic nose.
What do you think would be unusual?
Well, I'm a medicine person myself, and I thought because he was a medicine person that we would both say body.
Plastic body, the whole thing. Plastic
That's
brain.
That's why they make me wear the raincoat.
I see. Okay. Charles?
It's not every day you meet a doctor and a captain.
No.
And if I didn't agree with him, I'd be nuts.
Right. One brain for you, Captain. Are you offering a little brain?
No.
He certainly is.
I love it. I just would like the world to know that I respect you, Brett, because of your you're older than I and you're wiser.
And you have no taste.
No.
Plastic...
I said the wrong thing, Doctor. I'm sorry. Forgive me. I said a plastic woman. I kept thinking of Frankenstein's wife or something.
How would you like to be the first man on Earth to have a plastic woman, she said.
Yes,
he said brain. What did you say?
Yeah, I said woman or wife.
Woman or wife.
Oh,
Richard. Oh, I'll change it. I don't want to be like her. I didn't say anything.
Drew a blank.
I thought, Richard, I had more respect for you. I don't know why you said that. I mean, I said wife and woman.
Or woman, too.
Okay.
So it's one for you, and your question is coming up, Sue. But first, we've got this coming up for all of you.
Today's consolation prizes are West Fox Big Ben Futura, traditional Big Ben quality and craftsmanship, colorful, easy-to-read dials, adjustable alarm from West Fox, a Tally Industries company. A new, thicker, richer-than-ever-before dial shampoo. The shampoo with special managing agents leaves hair soft with a natural-looking shine. Dial shampoo. And a supply of Tropicana, the 100% pure orange juice, the orange juice from fresh oranges from Tropicana. Match game 74 continues.
Okay, here we go, folks. You ready? Let's find out what we got for Sue here.
Okay.
Sue, let's see. This is your first round question, so everybody plays.
Right.
Mark Goodson said, I've been watching Gene Rayburn lately, and if you ask me, it's about time to give him a blank.
What?
I'll give you a straight, flat reading on that because I don't want to lead you to one answer or another. Mark Goodson said, I've been watching Gene Rayburn lately, and if you ask me, it's about time to give him a blank. Do you know who Mark Goodson is? Mark Goodson
is... He's our boss.
Yes.
I thought so.
He's the packager of this program. Goodson Todman is the corporation. That, you know, they do a lot of shows, okay. And this is what you got the
I
idea.
Gotcha.
He's the boss, in fact.
Okay.
Mark Goodson said, I've been watching Gene Rayburn lately, and if he asked me, it's about time to give him a...
Raise.
A raise.
Yeah.
I hope you're listening, Mark.
Mark, are you listening? Greg? She says raise.
Well, I've met Mr. Goodson a couple of times, and he's famous for his senility, so I would have to say he'd say raise.
What is that?
No. I don't know
that. What do you say?
Raise for what?
A raise
to where?
A raise for doing a superb job on this program.
Not necessarily. But I said raise anyway.
All right, Charles?
Definitely, my friend.
All right, thank you. Boy, you know, you folks may be doing something for me because...
Yeah, you'd be looking for another job.
Yeah, how can you... I mean, how's he going to get out of this one? Go ahead.
Did you arrange this question?
No, I had nothing to do with it.
I think that's a cheap way to get employment benefits, but I say wait.
No, I have nothing to do with writing the questions. There are four characters over there, Pat Neary and Joe Neustein and Bobby Sherman, mm-hmm. and then Dick DeBartolo. They're the one they write all. I have nothing to do with them. Right. What did you say, sir?
What I do say is I wonder where they'll be working next week. No, I think, you know, you get, we all know what you get. You get $9.80 a week.
That's it.
And he's holding out for $10. So I say raise.
All right. That would be a 2% increase. What do you say?
You know, Gene, we've all seen you in the plaid pants outfit, you know.
Yes.
Definitely you need a raise.
So that's six for you.
Great.
All right, as we go to the second round, I point out to Captain Ronald Smith that you must match five celebrities to stay in the running. And that'll tie it, and we'll see what happens after that. Okay. You may make a selection, if you would.
I'll take A this time.
A. Now, Charles, you're the only one who will not participate. You may doze off if you wish.
You've been dozing off all through the program. I don't know why you should change now.
Sometimes for laughs, the three musketeers would blank each other. Sometimes for laughs, the three musketeers would blank each other. Would blank each other. Would blank each other. Well, I wasn't around in those days.
You sure weren't such a slow thinker.
Okay. Upper tier is ready, and so is the lower tier. So, we call on you, Captain Smith. Sometimes for laughs, the three musketeers would blank each other.
Kiss.
Would kiss each other? Well... To each his own. I mean, you know, they wore those frills and feathers and all that.
This
one
man,
for all and all for one. Well, listen. Yes, Greg. Kiss.
Come on.
No.
Goose each other.
Yes, duel. Rod, duel.
Fighter
duel would seem to have been the answer. There's another $100 for you, Sue. And Captain, I'm sorry it's been such a short meeting. We've enjoyed meeting you, and a gift for you backstage. Thank you, Captain Ronald Smith. Good luck to you in your career. You what?
I never win anything.
You never win anything?
Winning.
Why? Is that the story?
I'm a jinx.
The story of your life is you never win anything?
I don't win.
Well, you're up to $300 now, and you're going to have another go at the Big Money Super Match where you can win over $5,000. So let's get to it. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Blank Morris. Now, you know how it goes, 500, 250, and 100. And which ones you want some help from?
Okay, Richard again.
Richard.
Philip.
Morris.
Oh, dear. Philip Morris is what he says.
Okay, let's see, Anne.
But they don't know that.
Anne.
I said William Morris.
William?
You said William Morris.
I know, it's the first time I've said their name in 4 years and they represent me. That's an agency, I have to say.
And it says, you think all those studio audience people would have said that, huh?
It's all
so many
I'm
actors
sorry,
out of work, they could have been in the audience.
That's right. Okay.
That's true.
One more.
Charles.
Where's he going?
He stuck an arrow right in your head, Greg. There. Okay, so Greg Morris, Philip Morris, and William Morris.
I'm so mad.
And you may choose one of those. Don't feel bad, Ann.
Okay.
We've had worse. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
I'm going to go with Greg.
You're going to go with Greg? Okay. Greg Morris. Greg Morris. Okay. That's the one we're looking for. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Chester Morris. Chester Morris.
He used to work on Gunsmoke.
Right.
He's a wonderful.
Change his name to William.
We're looking for Greg Morris. Here is the $250 response. What's under the $500 there? Let's see. Take a look at that. What do you think? Philip Morris is up there.
Okay. You want to know funny?
What?
My son's name is Philip.
No kidding. Well, he would have won the money. Listen, we've got to pause here for a second, Sue. You stand by. We've got this for you. Join us next time for Match Game 74. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Gene.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74. Amar Goodson, Bill Todman production.
He gave her a wink.
Right.
It meant that
right.
He was going.
Congratulations.
Well, see me.
It's adios time.
It's adios time is right. I'm sorry to see you go. You've been a very personable and interesting contestant.
You know, I just figured out what the initial CB stand for.
What?
Checkbook.
Checkbook. Well, he's got a lot of money to put in that checkbook.
Right.
$14,050. Congratulations.
Thank you.
TV Barnsworth. Wink, eh?
Yes, wink. It's a logical thing.
All right.
Sorry.
Now, Sue, you've never been here before, so let me just explain. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Open blank. And the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Then if you go for the second one, it's $250. And if you match the third one, it's $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
What do you say?
The words of Sabu. Open sesame.
Open sesame. Okay, there's one.
Charles.
Charles, what do you say to this? Open.
Open the door, Richard.
That's an
old
song.
Throw out the tapes.
You know, and throw out the tapes. No, open the door, Richard, is an old rock song. What do you, who else?
Okay, Greg.
Greg.
Me?
Oh, have boy. You got one? Open.
Yeah. Account.
Open account.
Don't groan. It stinks.
All right. Open account, open the door, Richard, and open sesame. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own. What would you like to do?
Open sesame.
You would like to open sesame. Okay, that's the one that Richard gave you. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where? First, may we see the $100 response? Open sesame is there. I thought I knew it was going to be there. I had a feeling it was going to be there, but I figured it'd be a little higher there. I'm curious to see what's under the $250 response.
Open and shut.
Open a door. Would that have matched open the door, Richard? Yeah, I guess it would have, okay? What do you think is under the $500? Open house.
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
I had that.
None of the dummies up here thought of that, did they?
I did.
Oh, you thought of it. Oh, all right. Okay. Let's find out what's under the $500 response. Open house is right, audience. Okay. You've got the $100, Sue. That means you now play for 10 times that amount or $1,000. To collect, you have to match one celebrity. Which one will it be?
I'll try Richard.
Richard. Okay, you get ready to write. You're going to face me. Here is the $1,000 question. This will have to be an exact match. Wash blank. That's W-A-S-H blank. All right, he's finished. Now, Sue, we call on you to give us an answer you think will match Richard's. Wash
day.
Wash day. All right. She says wash day will match you, Richard. What do you say? How do you respond to that?
She wants me, I'll be in the washroom.
Oh. In the washroom.
I'm sorry, Dawson.
She can't follow you in there, then.
Well, there's an assumed
washcloth, and there are a number of good choices there. You didn't get together in that one. You're up to $200. You're going to play another game right after we have this message of interest for all of you.
Somebody should
get ready to match the stars. Greg Morris, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, and Meara. Richard Dawson and Ann Elder as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Oh, thank you, Johnny Olsen. Thank you for being with us today. It's a pleasure to do business with you. How is everyone up here? And everybody down here is all right?
Fine.
I forgot to tell everybody that Ann Elder was nominated for an Emmy for writing the Lily Tomlin special. She's writing another Lily Tomlin special. And what else are you writing?
Well, it's funny. The networks have asked me to come up with the best of two possible shows that are on the air. One is The Waltons. And the other is Hawaii 5-0, and they're going to call it Pineapple's Way.
Oh! All right, we're going to watch that. You just lost the Emmy.
Emmy for that.
No, she's also up for the C.B. Farnsworth show.
That's right.
Farnsworth show.
There's C.B. Farnsworth, our current champ, and Sue Hagee, his challenger. Hello there, how are you, C.B.? He's won a lot of money, $14,050. And how many games? How many games? Three games you won, right?
Three games.
Yeah. How do you feel?
Nervous.
No. How can you be nervous after winning all that money? Money makes you feel secure.
No, it doesn't.
How do you feel, Sue?
Very nervous.
All right. We're going to start with round two right after we give you a round of commercials. Here they are. Ready to go. Round two. Final round. 5-4 in favor of Sue. And, Sue, you make a selection, if you would.
B, please.
You don't.
She wants B. Now, the only person who is playing
is Dr. Schweitzer.
That's right. Shall we read it together? No, I'll read it aloud to you.
No.
Charlie said, I have my income tax prepared by a trained monkey. You ought to try him. He works for blank. There it is.
Charlie said, I have my income tax prepared by a trained monkey. You ought to try him. He works for blank.
Right. He can read, too. Isn't that terrific?
Fantastic.
Did you hear it, Sue? Charlie said, I have my income tax prepared by a trained monkey. You ought to try him. He works for... Now, don't say it now. Wait till she finishes writing. Say something.
All right.
Anything.
The trick is she hasn't learned to write, so that's what makes it so hard for her.
All right. Sue? Charlie said, I have my income tax prepared by a trained monkey. You ought to try him. He works for...
Bananas.
Bananas. He works for bananas, is what she said. He works for peanuts would have been a good answer.
That's right.
What else would have been good? Let's make her feel great.
I know an answer that's going to cause her entire career in about 2 seconds.
Really? Okay, may we see yours?
He works for...
I said it, and I don't care. I wish I had the same guy that worked for him.
Richard Nixon. Okay. Now, CB, you need...
I need...
One to tie, two to win. Ready?
No.
Okay. Now, Brett and Ann.
Wait a minute.
Yeah, Brett and Ann are the only two. You're the only two who play.
Oh.
All right, ready. Just for Brett and Ann.
I have to...
Sharon wrote this poem, about her new husband. Before we were married, he gave me a mink. But this year for Christmas, he gave me a blank. It's a poem.
Well, I'm trying to rhyme it, sweetheart.
All right.
When we were married, he gave me a mink. But this year for Christmas, he gave me...
Would you like to do your dance?
What's your name again?
I'm not finished.
Sharon.
Oh, you mean...
Hold it, just the two.
Ann?
She's finished, and we're waiting for you.
She's finished?
She's finished.
She has rhythm, too, Jim.
Oh,
yeah.
That's it.
Brett's got rhythm.
Brett's got rhythm, according to Greg Moore.
I got rhythm.
That's enough. Stop fiddling with my cable.
No.
CB, Sharon wrote this poem about her new husband. Before we were married, he gave me a mink. But this year for Christmas, he gave me a...
Drink?
Drink. Drink is the answer. He's looking. He needs one to tie, two to win. Brett. Hello, Brett, testing 1-2.
Oh, I wish that I couldn't think of anything that rhymed with me.
So what'd you put?
Stinks.
Now you know how I feel. Now you know the humiliation.
He's hoping you're going to say drink. Tell us what you did say.
I figured the marriage was ending.